Welcome to Economy, guys. It's Basil here with a Samsung Galaxy S4 and an HTC One. We're giving you a quick comparison of the two phones. Flagships in every single respect. The S4 is Samsung's brilliant new phone with a 1080p display, 7.9 millimeter skinny chassis, and a whole host of smart features that really separate it from the crowd. But HTC's phone is an absolute design classic. Its aluminium unibody chassis just feels so rich, and it innovates in its own right with stereo speakers and an infrared remote control up top. But which is better? Well, we're going to start off with the design, and it kind of is a giveaway that the beautiful unibody design of the HTC One wins over the Samsung Galaxy S4. Don't get us wrong, Samsung have done some amazing things with the S4. As we said, they've killed the bezel, making this large 5-inch screen device really thin looking. It fits in the hand perfectly. The HTC One's a little bit smaller at 4.7 inches. Packing a full HD display, it gives it a higher PPI. The screens are opposing technologies. You've got AMOLED technology on the Samsung Galaxy S4. You've got an LCD 3 on the HTC One. LCD 3, by the way, delivers incredibly sharp pixel density, 468. So that's going to produce a sharper image than the S4. But the S4 is going to produce more eye-popping colors with its AMOLED screen tech. We can immediately see on both devices, viewing angles are absolutely second to none. Both have a really gorgeous superficial quality to the screens. They literally look flushed with the surface of the actual glass. The Samsung Galaxy S4 doesn't look quite as flushed as the S3. One thing the Samsung Galaxy S4 does have is super sensitive touch. So whether you're wearing gloves, whether you're using your fingernails, it's actually going to be operable perfectly well. Another area Samsung really innovates is in terms of the UI, so that's where we're going to go on to next. Kicking off with Android version numbers, and you've got Android 4.2 on the S4. On the HTC One, it's Android 4.1, so it is a version behind. You've also got some cool smart features on the S4, so if we jump into the gallery, for example, we can hover over our sensors to scroll through the photos. If we jump back into the gallery, we can immediately see, if we jump back a step again, putting our finger above the actual gallery album will open up really neatly the preview of the album. It doesn't stop there. This is operable in web browsing, so you can scroll through web browsing, etc. And the sensors even detect when your eyes are open. Will it work? Well, you'll have to wait for us to get this in for review before we give you the verdict on the eye sensors. But initially, we're pretty impressed with the way it operates in terms of the smart, the scrolling functionality. HTC has introduced something a lot more traditional on their HTC One, and that's something called Blink Feed. It'll give you a scrolling feed of all your news and Twitter and Facebook feeds. It looks really attractive. We're not actually connected to the internet now, so it's not pulling in the pictures. But were we to be connected, it would pull in a really rich stream of feed. And if we tap through on elements, it would open them up in their native applications, Twitter, after giving you a brief preview. If we look at other elements of the user interface, HTC's packed Sense 5 on board here. It's got a really clean iconography. You can see they've simplified everything and introduced things like folders into the home screen. TouchWiz on the Samsung Galaxy S4 is a lot more busy. It's also pretty functional. If we, for example, long press the back button, we can pull a multitask window open. So we can actually have multi-window where we have half the screen occupied by one app, half by another app. Both of these devices really do compete head-on with very different feature sets. So it's exciting times in the world of mobile. Under the hood, you're going to find 32 gigabytes of memory internal on the HTC One. Samsung are all about giving you options. You can have 16 gigabytes of memory on board for the same price as you get 32 on the HTC One. Well, a little bit more actually. But they also offer a 32 gig option and a 64 gig option, as well as micro SD expandability. So if you're a memory fiend multimedia muncher, then you are going to love the Samsung Galaxy S4 on that front. Both devices give you Dropbox storage for free. The Samsung Galaxy S4 gives you 50 gig, the HTC One 25 gigabytes, and that's for 2 years. As far as the processor goes, Qualcomm 600 CPUs in both. Clocked to 1.7 gig on the HTC One, 1.9 on the Samsung Galaxy S4. If we're completely honest, you really won't notice those 0.2 gigahertz difference. However, it is there for all you spec heads. finally wrapping up on battery life, and the HCC1 battery life does last the full day, but with a whopping 2600 milliamp battery, the Samsung Galaxy S4 is expected to supersede this, lasting a day, even a day and a half. Like we said earlier, before we can really test this feature out, we're going to get them in for review. And one thing we didn't mention, which we absolutely have to, are the cameras. You've got a 4.3 megapixel camera on the HTC One. Now this is an ultra pixel camera, so each pixel is slightly larger. So don't get put off by the small pixel count. It performs incredibly well in low light, and with optical image stabilization, is very, very cutting edge. The Samsung Galaxy S4 packs a 13 megapixel camera, so you've got a lot more dots there picking up information, but with smaller pixels, they're not going to be as capable of grabbing light. What does that mean in terms of the verdict? Well, we can't really tell you because we haven't put the Samsung Galaxy S4 camera through its paces. Initially, gauging by how we reviewed the Samsung Galaxy S3 and the Sony Xperia Z, both packing more pixels, they're very comparable. The HTC One does do better in low light than the aforementioned. However, the S3 and the Xperia Z pack a little bit more detail in there. We believe that's finished up wrapping the comparison of the Samsung Galaxy S4 and the HTC One down. If you've got any questions, anything we've missed, please fire us a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, click like. If you like our channel, click subscribe.